In 1976, South Africa was burning. Children ran through the streets of Soweto, fanning the flames. A fuel crisis rocked an increasingly embattled government. The country simmered on the coals of furious anger. But some things are better forged in fire. In 1976, while most South Africans were battening down the hatches, Bob Rightford, Brian Siltrip, and Roger Macon were opening doors. Rightford, Siltrip, and Macon, the little yellow ad agency, was fueled by a spirit of hope and optimism and a little bit of fire. Together, they told the stories that became the treasured heartland of South African advertising, stories that built some of the country's biggest brands.
I call everything I love Soweto.
Stories that even today live on in our memories. It was a company of truth, integrity, optimism, friendship, happiness, and pride. No bullshit, no lying, no cheating, no internal politics, and definitely no apartheid. In the midst of a broken country, the little yellow agency strived to create a new reality. And pretty soon people sat up and noticed. It was strong work. It was bold work. For the first time, someone actually talked to the majority of people the government had always ignored. Stories that played out across the nation, that crossed old boundaries. It was work created with a clown in the head and a love in the heart. This story will carry the reader on an incredible journey. A journey where the impossible became possible. A journey through the exciting first 19 years of the agency's phenomenal growth and rapid rise to the company that dominated South African advertising for nearly four decades. From the rise of the South African worker hero in the iconic Carling Black Label ads. To the undercurrents of the black consciousness movement powering the incredible sales house work, Rightford's broke all the rules.
I am a woman of Africa.
They rewrote the rules. Together with a few brave clients, they created some of the biggest success stories in South African business. It was work that changed things in a country that was changing just as fast. At its best, advertising has the power to shape society, to shape the future, to change lives. The Rightfords way, the new way, acknowledged that there were new emerging market forces in South Africa. For the first time, an agency and their clients talked to those in the townships. New categories emerged along with those new consumers, creating huge opportunities for brave companies and brave ad agencies. These new prospects needed to be identified and understood, and Rightford, Siltrip and Macon's intimate involvement ensured that they stayed ahead of the game. The little yellow agency was now attracting some big league attention, and in 1985, Rightford, Siltrip and Macon merged with Ogilvy and Mather to create what was to become the largest agency in South Africa. It wasn't long before the legendary David Ogilvy, probably the most famous ad man of them all, rated them the best Ogilvy and Mather agency in the world. Few agencies, he said, have achieved the level of preeminence in their sphere of operations that Ogilvy and Mather, Rightford, Siltrip and Macon has enjoyed in South Africa. The company became the largest and is still number one today. In 1995, 20 years after the little yellow agency opened its doors, Advertising Age magazine voted it the International Agency of the Year, the best advertising agency in the world. Yet the proudest achievement of this company was something else. It gave so many the opportunity to become the best that they could be, to achieve more than they believed they were capable of. Today, many of South Africa's top ad agencies are run by men and women who pass through those yellow doors. Ogilvy, Rightford, Siltrip and Macon is not just a business. It is one of the great untold stories, a story of audacity and hope, a story of a South African company forged in fire and shining brightly on the world stage. Most of all, it is a story of how three brave men, with a clown in their head and a love in their heart, showed that if you believe, anything is possible.
I remember the days of my life. I recall the faces, mostly yours. This is my life, and I'm passing on the memory.